Welcome to church. We're just some group of people. Some call us believers. You ask why we gather? Well, so pastor can teach us. He preaches and leads us in ways of the Father. Without an hour of him each week, we'd be goners. We come to refuel, to renew what we used on weekdays because we paid some quite severe dues. And so we walk in on empty, all spent, and when we don't get what we need, we fire shots on friendlies. Impatience runs rampant. We're tired and we're mad, and that child won't quit crying. Just take it out back. And if the music's not soothing or the genre is off, then the emotional high that we strive for is gone. And we leave here dejected, like the whole week's a loss. Like, how could we live like Christians when church did us wrong? Welcome to church. We're just some group of people. Some call us believers. You ask why we gather? Is it so someone can feed us? I might be talking to church folks, so I'll make sure it's church spoken. I try not to hurt folks, though sometimes it hurts when the word is spoken. But church folks always insist, like, amen, we're ready for this. Claim to want to hear truth before you know what this truth is. But now we're already in it. Matter of fact, some might be offended. God forbid it, but honestly, sometimes we're all that sensitive. And that's what my point is, that it's pointless to be poignant when I'm pointing this out. Because if what I said criticizes, then you might just begin shutting down. And now we got churches filled with clergies that are nervous about all that they say because the members are all sinners, but intolerant of all each other's mistakes. Welcome to church. We're just some group of people. Some call us believers. You ask why we gather? Well, it's clear we're in need of not just the Savior, but the person we're next to. Because no matter how bad they sing or they dress, you find comfort in knowing the things that they've been through are probably the same things you're trying to get through. They're human just like you, and they like you despite you. And you know they've been mad and discouraged at times too. But each week they find you, they try to sit by you, and if not, they always wave high and wave bye too. And in case they missed you, it's not that they dissed you. They're probably just off because they're dealing with life too. And see, that's who we all are. We're different, but just one. All being chased down by God with insane love. All on the same road, going the same place, after the same goal, running the same race. The only thing different between us is signs. See, your mile marker's just different than mine. And all that that means is those bumps in the road have been hit by others who sit in your row. Yes. Welcome to church. We're just some group of people. Some call us believers. You ask why we gather? That's because Jesus freed us. He met us right there where our most desperate need was. So we keep coming here because others might need us. I come here to serve you because we're all in the body. Just because I run sound booth or greet in the lobby, just because there's a mic in my hand when the song sings, or I pass out the bites of the bread or the offering, please do not even begin to think I think I'm anything more than you. That's not how I see. I see the cross and the place that it brought me. I boast in nothing but him who first sought me. And because of all this, I can say confidently, welcome to church. Here's how it ought be. Zero offense. Sisters and brothers, people drawn in because we're loving each other. Who cares who can sing or whose style is whack? We're all on the same team. We all got the same dad. I certainly don't have the same giftings as you, but that battle you're fighting, man, I've been fighting too. So let's just unite and do battle together. Then we'll find success and we'll help whoever. And whoever needs help needs covered as well. Just like we needed covered when we fought through hell. And well, I can't say why Christ died for this purchase. But welcome to church. This is what church is.